all here gathered in his home to worship him, to bless him, and to thank him for his love and for his mercies. To thank him actually for he is the good shepherd who guide our life in this world. We know that the evil is the Lord of the darkness, and he wants all of us to stay in the darkness. So that's why Jesus, he said, I am the light of the world. So who believe in Jesus, the light will abide in him and will guide him, and at the end of his life he will inherit the kingdom of God. And we can see from the reading that we read today, according to the Gospel of Saint John, chapter 3, how come that the people that they say that Jesus, he came actually to condemn the world? This is not the truth. That's why the Bible say about Jesus that he said, and this is the condemnation, that the light has come into the world and men love darkness rather than light because their deeds were evil. So he is the one who come to give us the lightness. He is the one he who came not to condemn us, but actually to save us. But for those who, people who love and like the darkness, actually we could see that their deeds actually it's hidden because they like the darkness, and their deeds it is in the darkness. That's why something very interesting, if we follow the liturgy, especially if we come to attend it from the beginning, the very first word we sing when we begin our liturgy, anybody can tell me what is it, the first word, the first song? Nohroch. Nohroch, it means a new light. Nohroch, hozina, nohroch. And this is actually, it's a verse from Psalm of David, Psalm 36, when he said, in your light, we shall see the light. This is the very, actually, first word we sing when we begin the liturgy. So in his light, we can actually walk. That's why the light, according to the church and to the Bible, has very significant and important place. As I just mentioned, say, Jesus, he said, I am the light of the world. And in the light, actually, we can see the whole things. When we get into the room, the very first thing we do, we switch the light on. Because without actually light, we cannot walk in the room. Unlike the darkness, we cannot see nothing. And also in the light, we can walk peacefully without actually having fear that we will fall or anything. Unlike again the darkness, we scared, we put our hands, and we actually count to 10 before we make any single mistakes. That's why the light is very important. And again, if we will go to the very first thing the Bible mentioned in the book of Genesis, and this is actually Genesis 1:3. So we're talking about the very, very early thing in the Bible, that God, before anything, in the day one, he created the light. And if we continue, I don't know how many of you, when they read especially Genesis 1, when we read the story of creation according to the Christian faith, that the first day God created the light. And in the fourth day, God created the sun and the moon. We all know that the source of the light is the sun. But we can see this, if anybody will read it, and a lot of people, they say, how come God created the light, then he created the sun? While we know that the source of the light is coming from up, from sky, from the sun. But actually the book want to tell us something very important, that the source of the light is God Himself, not the sun. That's why the first day God created the light, then the fourth day He created actually the sun. So we need, as a Christian, to understand the significance and the importance of the light. So when we walk and when we walk and when we think dark in the darkness, we can understand that we need the light to walk in actually the right path. And not only that, almost the last verses in the whole Bible, in the book of Revelation, the Bible telling us that the light is very important, but the light that we talk about it will disappear. That's why the Spirit says to John to write, he said, there will be no more light. They will not need the light of a lamp or the light of the sun, for the Lord God will give them light. So we have to understand the real light, the true light, is the Lord Himself. Even we have a source of light, the sun, and maybe we have the power now, but actually the real light that we are all looking for actually is the Lord Himself. So that's why when we read the gospel at the very beginning of the liturgy, we see two deacons, they holding candles and standing here, because we want to tell this is the light that we have all. The reading that we were reading from the gospel, it will enlighten our heart and our life. So the two candles, one is the light and the other one is the light. That's why to understand the liturgy is very important, and we will enjoy it more and more. And then Jesus Himself, He said, I am the light of the world. And somewhere else in Matthew, He said, you are the light of the world. A lot of people, they struggle. They say, are we the light or He is the light? Who is actually or the true light? Again, I will go back to the sun and to the moon. We all know the moon that has no light in itself. But the sun has light, and the moon only reflect the light of the sun. And that's why at night we can see the moon, how bright and how good color is. Because the reflection of the sun lights. We also, as a Christian, Jesus is saying, I am the true light. I have the true light. But if you have me in you, you will reflect my light, so people will see your good deeds, your light, which is the faith and the good deeds that you do, and they will look and ask for the light that you have and will believe in me. I was reading a story of a Japanese people when they began to have teachers and professors from all over the world to teach, because they want, after the Second World War, they want actually to develop their countries. So there was a missionary in America. He been accepted to go to teach there. But in the contract, they asked him that he is not allowed to talk about the faith of the religion at all. He can teach, he can be with the student, but he cannot talk about his faith at all. So he accepted the contract. After almost 2 years, one of the teachers, he went to that class, and he found out that a lot of his students, they have crosses on their necks, and they believe in Jesus. So they asked him, why did you broke the contract? He said, I never ever spoke about Jesus or faith. Nobody knew that I am a Christian even. They didn't believe him, of course, and they asked the student, they said, why you believe in his God? Why you listen to him? They said, we did never ever ask him about his faith. But we could see how good person he was. He was always on time. He used to treat us not only as a student, but as a children and as a sons. He loves us, and he was always there for us when we needed him. So one time we asked him, why you are like this? He only said, because I believe in Christ. That's the only thing he said. So because of his answer and because of his behavior, they all decide to have faith in his God because they want to be like him. So if we have the light in our heart, if we have Jesus in our heart, we will be able to reflect through our deeds and through our behaviors the true light that we have, and then we can ask people, even without preaching them or talking to them, we can tell them how the Christ is good. A lot of people, they live different lives. When they come to the church, they think Jesus only here in the church. So when we say, let's pray the prayer of confession, they pray. But if you go ask their families, how was your mom, how was your dad, how was your son, you will hear amazing story about how this person in the church is different than the one who is in home. And if you go ask those who works with him, also you will see how tough he is, how he is not actually respects others. We need, dear brothers and sisters, to understand that without having the true light in our heart, we will have actually double life. When we will come to church, we will be good people. But outside, we will put Jesus on side. A lot of people, they say, Abuna, to be Christian and to work with other people, it's not easy. While Jesus, he told us, if we believe in him, that we will become very, very respectful people. We will respect ourselves, then we will respect others. That's why to have the true light, when actually Jesus said, the true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. So the true light is Jesus. He is the one who come to this world. So who he believe in him will receive actually the true light and will abide in him. That's why the Bible invited us as the children of the light, as the sons of the light, how we should be. First, actually, when we have the light, we will have the fellowship with the light, which is with God himself. Because the one who has the light, he has a very important fellowship with God. Like the Bible says, God is light. In him there is no darkness at all. If we claim to have a fellowship with him and yet walk in the darkness, we lie and do not live out the truth. So to have this fellowship and to live the participation of being true children and true sons of the light, we need to have this faith in him and to invite him in our heart. And also the light is will give us story how to love others. And this is very important, since we know a lot of people, they are have a broken relationship with their relatives, their brothers. And while we come to church, we hear the word of God and we pray and we receive communion, but on other hand, we still have a lot of people we don't talk with. That's why the Bible says, the one who says he is the light, but hates his brother or sister is in the darkness until now. The one who loves his brother or sister remain in the light. So we can understand, if we have the light, I'm still talking about God, Jesus, in my life, that light should be shine on others. Number one, my brothers and my sisters. This is what the Bible says. If you don't talk with them, if you don't reconcile with them, if you don't have good relationship with them, how come you say, I have God in me? I have the light. Because the light would open your eyes and you will recognize that what you're doing is not right. And you have to repent and go do more than what you expect. You have to go reconcile with those people. That's why the Bible says, because the darkness has blinded their eyes. So when we don't have the light, the darkness or evil will actually close or will blind our eyes. So we can see how important is the light, is the source of the love, the source of the righteousness, source of the truth, source of how to be ready always to share the good news with everybody. So we can ask ourselves, what is the darkness? Actually, everything else or opposite of what I just said is the darkness. When I don't love my brother, when I don't say the truth, when I don't have fellowship with God, when I don't live righteousness life, that means I have the darkness in my heart. That's why the Bible says, when I was reading the gospel today, the light has come into the world, but people love darkness instead of light because their deeds were evil. So I think if anybody is still have darkness in his heart, because he hide the bad deeds. So no, he doesn't want anybody to see his bad behavior. That's why he remained and he lived in the darkness. Again, we as a Christian, not only we have the true source of light, but actually we are all invited to be light of the world. Again, imagine in your work, in your family, are you really shine your faith among your family and the people that you know? A lot of people, they came to me if we speak in the ceremony or when we visit the homes. They say, Abuna, the people that I know, they made me Christian people, they made me not to go to church or not to practice my faith. Actually, because the darkness that these people, they live in, and they have bad deeds they have in this darkness, that's why a lot of people, they struggle in their faith. So we as a Christian, we need to open our heart and to allow the true light to come and to dwell and to remain and to live in our heart. So all our deeds, it will be actually the deeds of light. May God bless you all. And I ask our Heavenly Father to bless you again. The very first thing God created is the light. I think this is very important message for all of us. If we need to walk in the light, we need to believe in Jesus and to open our heart and to give our life to Him. Then He will guide us in the light. Let's all of us stand up and pray the prayer of confession. Ask Him to take all the darkness from our life. And not only that, sometimes we have to work hard, because